Welcome to Feed Dump, where we're boning up on our fundamental interactions of physics. I am gravitation. Joining me this week is the strong nuclear force.
You said boning.
And electromagnetism.
Ow.
And I don't know what the three of us are doing, but perturbation theory doesn't rhyme with news. A Washington, D.C. school teacher has been fired after assigning third-grade math problems centered around violent and illegal acts. John's father gave him 1,359 marbles on his birthday. John swallowed 585 marbles and died. 9 of John's friends came for his funeral the next day. John's grieving father gave the remaining marbles to John's friends in equal numbers. How many marbles did each friend get?
That math teacher is like the guy from Saw.
Hello, Daniel. I want you to solve for X.
Maybe this is a good way to get kids interested in doing math problems. You have, like, a train leaves one city going 20 miles an hour, and a train leaves the other city going 30 miles an hour. When will they cross, and will the bomb on one of the trains explode, killing everybody?
And if Bruce Willis jumps out of a helicopter 400 feet in the air, will he make it there in time?
Actually, yeah, screw teaching. This person obviously has a career in scriptwriting.
Boston Dynamics, creators of the coolest and creepiest robots, have just claimed the land speed record for robots, with their creation, the Cheetah, running 18 miles an hour.
And if you listen really carefully, you can hear your computer say, soon.
So how long until we actually see a race between an actual cheetah and the cheetah robot thing? Which I presume will start with the both on the starting line, and then the cheetah just running the other way, because it's a freaking robot.
And we're under starter's orders. Oh, and the cheetah has deployed the laser beam.
You really should have seen that one coming.
Really?
Time to play the guessing game. A chicken McNugget, shaped like whom, just sold for $8,100 on eBay.
I mean, the obvious answer is Jesus, but that seems too obvious. I'm gonna go with Oprah.
Colonel Sanders.
A chicken. Abraham Lincoln.
Lady Gaga.
Oh, wait, of course. Elvis. It's gotta be Elvis.
No, I don't even care. This is so dumb. That's not even gonna keep.
No, you eat it, right? Then you absorb the power of that person. It's a well-known fact that if you eat a chicken McNugget in the shape of a person, you get their power.
Also stupid, but makes more sense.
Well, then you would be very good at not telling lies, cutting down trees, and being the first president, because apparently it's shaped like George Washington. Although, and we don't normally show pictures on Feed Dump, this does not look a fucking thing like George Washington.
Wow, this is actually a good advertisement for whoever put that up on eBay or wherever and sold it. Because this is a person who I would want to sell anything that I own. Because obviously they know what they're doing.
I think you'll find this antique mahogany jewelry box is top drawer.
I'm pretty sure this is a hockey glove.
Top drawer.
All right, if you say so, $2,000. Can you imagine that as like an infomercial? It's like, sell your stuff with me. I'm the guy who sold a chicken nugget for $8,000.
Hi, Ron Dewings here for selling chicken McNuggets.
I don't know what it is. I just want to give him all my money.
A moviegoer in Detroit is bringing a class action lawsuit against AMC Theaters because their snacks are really expensive, which is apparently news now.
Wait, we're allowed to do that? We can complain that theater snacks are too expensive? Why didn't anybody tell me? Actually, the real problem is if the theater lowers its snack prices, then the grocery store around the corner from the theater is going to sue them for taking away all their business.
Would you care for any popcorn or soda, sir?
Oh, no, I'm not too hungry.
Okay,
yes, theaters overcharge. But everybody overcharges for pop and popcorn. If they charged the actual price for pop and popcorn, it would be like 10 cents.
The 2012 British Olympic team has been advised by its team doctor to not shake hands with any opposing athletes or visiting dignitaries during the games.
The British Olympic team's head doctor actually just had a really bad breakup with the head doctor of another Olympic team, and so he just wants to diss them really badly.
Are we sure it was their doctor and not, like, their grandmother? Now don't go touching any of them dirty strangers, they'll give you the cholera.
And now, for the benefit of our 2012 Olympians, Feed Dump presents the alternatives to handshaking.
The elbow.
The mime.
The force of will.
The ET.
Is it Ew.
Gross,
ew,
gross.
Ew. The hat toast. I say good lad.
Kink.
Bottoms up.
The safety.
The super safety.
So there you have it. Don't say we never did nothing for you. Until next time, remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat, which is bright green and covered in mushrooms. I'm not sure how I feel about it. I believe it is actually dissolving my skull.
This will tend to make you very high.